What have you seen from Lonzo so far?
Well, the good thing about Lonzo, he started early. He was in the weight room. We asked him to get stronger. And, man, he put in the time. And then the one thing that we were really blown away with is that he wanted to watch film. And so it can't be us asking him to do that. Mm-hmm. He had to want it for himself. And he wanted to sit and watch film with me and with Rob. And we had, I don't know, three or four sessions. And then Rob just told you what happened with, all four of us, with Rondo included, and Lonzo. So it was really wonderful to be in another film session with him. But he's starting to understand that he has to be better. But he understood that right after the season. And we explained that this is going to be, the most important offseason. And while he could be on the court, his shot looked great. He's going to be ready to have a breakout season and build on what he did last season, because it was only a couple of things he had to do better. And so that was drive it to the basket and finish and get the mid-range in terms of really the get his shot where he's on balance. It's not his shot. He just has to be on balance. And I let the shooter, Rob, tell you more about that, because Rob really talks about that with him, because Rob was a shooter his whole life. So I'm the assist man, so I talk to him about turnovers and things like that. But anyway, I think that I'm excited for Lonzo, and he's going to be fine.
Yeah, I think Lonzo and I were sitting out. We have a little outdoor eating area the other day, and I think all of us have had our own life journeys. And sometimes in life, you don't fully appreciate something until it's gone, right? We've all had stories like that in our life. And for him to go through this off season where he's had several months where he couldn't be playing 5-on-5, I think he's got this deeper sense of appreciation about the game and what it means for him. I can just see it in his spirit and in his energy. And then he has worked to just add more fluidity to his shot. You can see the spin and kind of the release where it is. He knows that he's not going to just be called upon to do one thing, push the ball and pass, but he's going to, with all our multiple ball handlers, he's going to have to at some times be ready to play off the ball and catch and shoot. So he has worked hard on that, and we've seen advancements in all things. So in terms of the official update on his sort of medical status, the news has been great. He's been 100% cleared by our medical staff to return to full basketball activity. Because he hasn't played NBA 5-on-5 for 4 or 5 months, there is, with any player that has surgery, a progression to come back. So he started that progression. He will participate in our training camp and everything other than 5-on-5 contact drills at the beginning, but we'll progress along that continuum and we'll just take it a day at a time. There's no way to predict the future, but the fact that he's been 100% cleared and is feeling great is good news. Just to piggyback off something Magic said to kind of give you guys a further insight to the reality of this mentorship and the leadership of these older players or more veteran players. The other day, great idea. It was Magic, Rajon, and Lonzo in the film room, and we put on the Pelicans-Lakers game from last season. So you had Rondo leading the Pelicans, you had Zoe. It was a great game. It was like 128-124. It went down to the end. And I had set it up by saying, okay, Rondo, take us through as you have the ball and as plays are unfolding, just narrate, what's going on in your mind, how you're seeing things unfold, how you're leading your team. Then we asked Zoe to do the same thing. Hey, what are you thinking in this moment? How are you setting up this player? And then you got the best point guard that's ever played the game on layered on top of that. So If that was a pay-per-view event, I think it would have sold a million tickets. But it was amazing to be in that room and to hear these three point guards talking about the game and breaking it down. And that's just one example of the thousands of things that are going to go on in camp throughout the year, where these guys all become better.